Hi everyone. Today, let me show you through another university exam, but this time on the topic of psychology. I have here with me an introductory psychology exam from MIT, and I'll go through the paper and have a little look at what the format of questions is and what kind of topics they're asking you about. You might find this interesting if you're considering studying psychology or you even want to see what you might be missing out on. MIT make a lot of their course materials available online, so I'll put a link in the description to this exam, as well as a lot of the other notes and lectures for this course. You might be surprised and think that this exam actually appears a little bit easy, especially considering it comes from MIT, but keep in mind that this is an introductory course, and I think that there are only so many ways that you can teach and examine the fundamentals of a topic. Maybe the difference between universities comes in more as you get into the later stages and the more advanced concepts in a topic. But I think this course is designed to give students at MIT their first introduction to the topic. It's probably the first psychology course that they're taking, and they themselves want to see if they would make a good psychology major. So let's have a look at it. The exam tells us that the questions are all from lectures and from readings from an Oliver Sacks book. That book is called The Man Who Mistook His Wife for a Hat and is a bunch of case studies written by a neurologist. This exam is one of three exams for the course, spread throughout the semester, with each exam worth 20% of the final grade. So this exam doesn't cover everything, but it does cover brain structure and function, methods of research, vision, consciousness, attention, memory, and learning. So let's have a look at this question, for example. At what point in the human visual system are neurons or axons that code for the same visual field from the two different eyes first brought together anatomically? The answer, I've circled the answers for you, is optic chiasm. Going on, we're being asked about the results of a brain imaging study between men and women. We're asked about the major visual cortical pathways and a few facts about things like memory and recognition. For example, here's an easy one. We read about, well, it says 12 letters at a time is the answer. It's kind of a case of remembering the details. Much of this is really going to be a bit of a memory test. If you haven't remembered something because it's multiple choice, you might be able to deduce your way to an answer through some kind of logic. Maybe let's look at 17. Negative contrast refers to the finding that rat performance in a maze is worst at the end of the experiment for rats who, the answer is, initially receive a large reward and then are switched to a small reward. Maybe that makes sense, even if you haven't read that particular passage in the notes. But only a casual interest in psychology isn't going to get you a high score here. A lot of these things involve jargon and concepts that you really need to have done quite a lot of study to know. When you watch dogs play in the park or watch how your professors conduct their classes, you are engaging in a form of what? Well, it's naturalistic observation. This course says that it's designed to introduce you to the scientific study of human nature. So we also have some questions that make sure we know about things like the scientific method and how psychology research would be conducted. We're asked here, you can use what to eliminate experimenter expectancy effects. So that's obviously something to do with experiment design. The answer is D, a double blind design. Exams like this for a course where there would be a lot of students taking it are not really designed to be extremely challenging. They're more designed, I think, to kind of make sure you've been paying attention, that you've done all the readings that you were supposed to do, and that you know what all of the key concepts are in the course. We get down to quite a funny question here, number 38. It says, take a look at the following figure. If you close your left eye and focus on the X while slowly moving the paper away from your face, what will happen and why? I kind of find this a funny question to have in an exam, because what you're going to have is hundreds of students sitting there with the paper in front of them, holding it up to their face and moving it slowly away. It will probably be quite a funny sight for the examiners. Well, the answer here was B, the picture will disappear when it lands on the part of your eye where ganglion cell axons come together to form the optic nerve, because there are no photoreceptors there. Question 42 references a particular study from the textbook. Garcia and colleagues discovered taste aversion in rats because A. The taste of water in plastic bottles was associated with sickness from radiation. That seems like an interesting study to read about. I took one introductory psych course of my own during undergrad, and I'd say it's pretty consistent with the kind of questions that were being asked here. This particular exam that I'm showing you is from 2011 though, so some of the topics could be slightly outdated, although it should be pretty much representative of what you'd see in a first psychology course. After the multiple choice questions, we get on to some short answer questions where I guess you pretty much just need to fill in the blanks or give some small written answers to the questions, like listing the four lobes of the brain, and for each lobe, list one of their functions. Give an example of each of the following: positive reinforcement, negative reinforcement, positive punishment, negative punishment. Hopefully that provided a little bit of insight for you into what it would be like to be in this class, but obviously it's going to be a bit strange looking just from the outside. You really need to be involved in all of this reading the books, the textbooks, and looking at the lecture notes before you'll probably really be able to do well at this. And check out the link in the description to the course if you want to maybe learn some of it for yourself. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.